This episode brought to you by PrepareWithDroneTech.com. These days, the future is still more uncertain than ever. That's why people who know what's coming are using today to prepare. You can't wait until the last moment. By then, it's too late. The most important thing you need is long-term storage emergency food. It stays fresh for up to 25 years and will be there when you need it. I strongly recommend My Patriot Supply, America's leader in self-reliance. They're the only source my family uses for emergency food planning. And right now, you can save $50 off a 4-week supply of delicious meals that provide 2,000 plus calories a day. Calories give you the energy you need to survive. And saving $50 is impossible to pass up, but supplies are limited. So go to www.preparewithdronetech.com right now and stock up. That's preparewithdronetech.com. There's no time to lose, do it now.
The Russian coverage of Trump is almost like an arm of the RNC, the way they cover Trump, the way they sort of follow his every move, the way they cover the Trump media echo chamber. You know who I'm talking about. What do you make of sort of this new Republican-Russian alliance as a geopolitical challenge for this White House?
These people just don't learn, even after the Steele dossier has been discredited and shown to be Russian disinformation, something that these people spread around the country in an attempt to undo the results of the 2016 election. The Republican-Russian alliance. It's a conspiracy theory that was just cooked up by the sociopathic liar Nicole Wallace and a couple random Democrats. Well, not completely random. One of them used to work for Obama and Biden. These lunatics are actually trying to push forward and mainstream the idea that Republicans are aligned with Putin, and that's the reason he's now threatening to attack Ukraine.
Rick, is there a sort of contraction of the options available? Is there a cumulative emboldening of Vladimir Putin from the last 4 years of the American political landscape? Is any American weakened by coming after Trump?
Democrats have been in control of this country for the past 12 months, but this hack, who has claimed to be a Republican for years, is now actually trying to blame Trump for emboldening Putin. Yeah, I'm sure it has nothing at all to do with the disastrous Afghanistan withdrawal, or the fact that Biden is clearly senile, or the fact that it was Joe Biden and Barack Obama who were in control the last time that Putin invaded Ukraine.
I mean, Vladimir Putin was watching your last segment with Bart. Nicole, I mean, he reads the newspapers. He reads the polls. Donald Trump probably sends him his internal polls. I mean,
he just baselessly claimed that Trump is secretly sending Putin internal polling information as if Putin needs Trump's help to get information that's public. What proof does he have of this claim? No doubt that if he had any, he would have presented it right there. But this is just the Democrat state media doing what they do.
He's testing Joe Biden now. He's looking at Biden's polling, he's looking at the midterms, he's looking at the possibility that America will turn authoritarian and will have an authoritarian president in 3 more years.
Nope, that's bullshit. What Putin and everyone else sees is a senile, doddering old man who's one step away from full-on dementia. He sees our media actively producing obvious propaganda in Biden's defense and against his critics. He sees communist subversion doing its job in the form of wokeism in all of our institutions. If he sees any signs of authoritarianism in America, that would be it. Authoritarianism isn't one person. It's one person backed up by a base of support. Trump would have all of these institutions, as we already saw, aligned against him, making authoritarianism impossible. Biden, on the other hand, has the full support of all of these institutions, to the point they're redefining words to support his policies. Lastly, let me just remind you that this turd worked for Obama and Biden the last time that Putin invaded Ukraine in 2014.
The Russian coverage of Trump is almost like an arm of the RNC, the way they cover Trump, the way they sort of follow his every move, the way they cover the Trump media echo chamber. You know who I'm talking about. What do you make of sort of this new Republican-Russian alliance as a geopolitical challenge for this White House?
It's just amazing how these insane conspiracy theories just flow from their faces when they spend so much time accusing their opponents of doing that. Especially when the reality is that Putin has been making these moves when Democrats are in power. That's because Democrats project weakness. Wallace right now is interviewing the guy who was working for Obama and Biden the last time Russia invaded. It's just completely crazy. And when When it came to Ukraine, Obama refused to send them any support outside of basic medical supplies. Then Trump came in and gave Ukraine TOW missile systems, which is probably one of the only things keeping Putin from invading right now. And in recent memory, it was the Republicans who opposed Russia on their Nord Stream 2 oil pipeline, while it was Joe Biden who gave in and appeased Russia for the Germans. All right, folks, I just want to give you a taste of what we're going to be seeing as we get closer and closer to the midterms. Basically, the Democrats and their media are so scared of the walloping that's almost surely coming to them that they're literally willing to do anything to try and stop that. Like I said, the problem with the left, what makes them most dangerous, is that they seem capable of rationalizing anything in pursuit of their agenda. This is because they tell themselves wild conspiracy theories about saving the earth or the end of democracy, which in their minds justifies any action they decide to take. All right, folks, as always, if you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and subscribe. Then let me know what you think in the comments.